Deputy Shane Ross.
Thank you, Councillor. And I'd like to join with my colleagues, Deputy Micheál Martin and Deputy Gerry Adams, in expressing my sympathy to the Taoiseach for the bereavement and his family, and to thank him for being here today at a time which is very difficult for him. I'd like to in passing, comment on the fact that we have been discussing or mentioning the possibility of what will be in the budget next week, and to express my own fear that really this may be one of the last meaningful budgets in the history of this state if events take the sort of shape which they're looking to take in Europe in the next few weeks. And I refer specifically to the fact that the German Chancellor, Angela Merkel, said just last week that Europe should take one big step towards fiscal union. It appears to me that the deal which the Taoiseach, at the meeting which the Taoiseach will attend on the 9th of December, is beginning to shape up, beginning to come clearer, and that what we will have will probably be the weaker countries conceding fiscal union, including Ireland, and the stronger countries are allowing the ECB to release the funds and take the measures which will give the relief to the euro which is so necessary. That has serious implications for Ireland. It presumably means that we will be involved in treaty change, and the Taoiseach will have to go to the country suggesting fiscal union and the implications of it, which will be very serious for us, because it will involve the second surrender of our sovereignty in recent times. The first surrender was obviously to the European banks by the last government.
Thank you.
And that will be swapped if we get the deal which is looking possible for the surrender of our independence to the bigger European nations. What I want to ask the Taoiseach is this: what attitude will we take if we are faced with such a deal? And will he assure the House that he will never put any referendum to the Irish people that permanently hands over our economic and fiscal sovereignty to any external European body?
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Thank you for your kindness, Deputy Ross. Your question is a valid question. I'd like to say this. Clearly there's a difference between fiscal union and fiscal discipline. And what Chancellor Merkel has been talking about very clearly in public on the record is about fiscal discipline. The Chancellor's view is that countries sign on for a set of conditions, that these conditions should be seen to be enforceable. And her view at the meeting that I had with her was that the European Court of Justice should be enabled to impose sanctions upon a country that did not measure up in terms of its fiscal discipline in the way that it does its budgets. The French president would have a different view about the requirement for fiscal union. It's an entirely different matter, which deals with the subject of your question in respect of tax harmonisation and so on. So as far as we're concerned, on behalf of the government, we've made the point very clearly. We have never breached the Growth and Stability Pact. We support regulations and conditions that are enforceable, and we're actually gone beyond this ourselves in the context of the Troika now, where there's a forensic analysis on a regular basis, as you're aware, but also leaving that aside, where we intend to legislate next spring for debt break in our own legal system here, which means that as a country that has measured up in the context of not breaching these conditions previously, and we intend to go further and legislate for debt break ourselves. The question of treaty change and the question of an issue in the treaty being changed and amended is always one in this country under our constitution that is subject to legal advice from the Attorney General as to whether a referendum is required or not. But I've made it perfectly clear that irrespective of the argument about treaty change, and as you're aware, that's a huge process of intergovernmental conferences, conventions and so on, unless you decide to do it by a specific and very narrow amendment, which might or might not still require an issue of sovereignty being changed, which would ultimately require a referendum here. But the point is, the crisis is now, as Deputy Ross is only too well aware, and it's got to be dealt with the facilities and the tools now available. And from our perspective, I have not hitched our wagon to the concept of euro bonds, because you might well be storing up serious trouble for the country further down the line. Our view is that the European Central Bank should be the backstop of ultimate and infinite firepower to deal with the question of contagion that affects every country. As Deputy Ross is aware from his own study of history, in the 1930s, people assumed that banks that were well managed and well run could actually survive, when in fact they didn't. And they can't and won't in the future unless there is a credible backstop provided. That backstop must be dealt with in the immediate future by political consideration. Because even if you were on the assumption of having a concept of treaty change applicable to everybody or accepted by everybody, you still couldn't do it in time to deal with the question of the crisis that affects us now. So my perspective for the meeting on the 9th of December is to deal politically with the crisis we have now, Deputy Ross, and that means making political arrangements to provide a sufficiently credible backstop. Minister for Finance are meeting today to discuss some technicalities around this. The EFSF has failed to attract the confidence of the markets, and whether it's some combination of ECB and IMF or whatever, that's where the focus of political leadership and decision has to be made, and made quickly.
Thank you.
The question of anything beyond that is a matter for serious consultation, obviously, in this Parliament, with this House, and so on.
Thank you.
Deputy Ross.
Thank you,
Taoiseach. I understand your point about fiscal discipline, but the quote I'm using from Angela Merkel, where she specifically talked about fiscal union. Now, fiscal discipline may be the one step she referred to, but undoubtedly fiscal union is on the agenda, and it's undoubtedly going to be on the agenda on the 9th of December, even if it is put down the road. Could the Taoiseach then assure us that we are not going to allow the issue of tax harmonisation to arise at that meeting, and that you yourself will not countenance any talk, as any quid pro quo, of a change in the 12.5% corporate tax, which may well arise in that situation?
Well, the objective of our political direction here, Deputy Ross, is to retrieve Irish economic sovereignty for our people and for our country. That's been lost, if you like, in the sense that you're now subject to a bailout in the Troika programme. I have no intention, as I said before on many occasions, of agreeing to anything in relation to tax harmonisation. We've been very clear about our corporate tax rate, as everybody in the House has, which is set out very clearly across the entire spectrum, 12.5%, effective 11.9%, there for everybody to see, neither having moved up nor moved down, because it's a commission legal right and responsibility to produce papers, let's say, in respect of the common consolidated corporate tax base. Of course, we participate in discussions about those things. But the paper to be tabled on December the 9th is coming from President Van Rompuy in respect of his proposals here, which he was mandated to produce. And I've heard a lot of comment about what might or might not be in them. Suffice it to say that we have no intention whatsoever of doing anything to disrupt the confidence that is here in respect of inward investment in regard to our corporate tax rate. And I go back again, Deputy Ross, to the difference between fiscal discipline, which was the focus of the Chancellor's words, and fiscal union other countries might have a view about. So in the sense of the fiscal discipline, the problem is that countries signed on for conditions to which they have not adhered, and therefore this causes a lot of angst naturally for countries who are providing loans in situations like that. for our country. We've measured up in this programme to all the conditions and have never breached the Growth and Stability Pact, and are going to go further next year by actually legislating ourselves for tax break, for debt break. So from that perspective, we have absolutely no intention of doing anything disruptive to our corporate tax system here, and we will focus on every attempt that we can to retrieve our economic independence and sovereignty, which is a requirement of everybody in the country.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.